And he was really cool and very supportive.
Hey, I like your fashion. Down by law.
Yeah, that's some good fashion.
Yeah, that was cool. He was cool.
Well, Down by Law, it has been around for what, like, this is your fourth album, so how many years now?
Since 1991.
It's kind of hard to, like, you were playing with All and Dag Nasty. Do you see it as one whole body of work, or do you divide them?
No, each band that we did was pretty separate. I mean, they were all great bands, I hope, but Down by Law is Down by Law. I think it's my favorite one.
And you started off with DYS, Department of Youth Services,
yeah.
And that was described as hardcore, straight-edge music. And
right.
Are you still straight-edge after
Well,
years?
I really believe in the ideals of straight-edge. There's a certain...
And what are those ideals?
Sort of not feeling like you have to take drugs or drink to be cool, or smoke or whatever. It's kind of just, you know, it's just what it says, a straight edge. Like, if you stay straight and alert, you have an edge over people who are constantly getting messed up.
No, but I don't use drugs or drink or anything.
Is he more?
Yeah, it's kind of a label.
Together than you are.
I don't really like labels, you know. So I don't really use the label anymore.
Yeah,
right.
I hate labels also.
I think the
because some people take
cool.
that label and they sort of have this whole dogma attached
right.
to it.
Well, I also think that, you know, Down by Law is not a straight edge band. We have some people who drink in the band and some who don't, and it doesn't really matter as long as you're a productive person.
And your choice is for health and you just physical well-being.
Yeah, and some people just can exist drinking and smoking stuff, and some people don't do as well with that. So it's kind of like an individual choice.
Mm,
you know,
yeah.
Whatever suits you best is what it should be.
Right.
Jimi Hendrix wouldn't have been Jimi Hendrix if he didn't take massive amounts of drugs.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, for every person, there's a unique path.
Right. You're not trying to be judgmental.
Exactly.
On people.
Exactly.
Your music is really fast and very melodic, and there's these three-part harmonies that go throughout. And then at the very end of the album, it ends with this sort of barbershop quartet, like nice little a cappella thing. So are you guys closet sort of closet balladeers?
Well, we're Dean Martin fans.
Yeah, Dean. That's a Dean Martin song.
Uh-huh.
And Danny, our drummer, is a humongous Dean Martin fan,
mm-hmm.
and he taught it to us right then. We started singing it, and if you can hear in the background, the producers are just saying, "This sucks, turn it off, stop." And they were so bad that we decided to force them to put it on.
Well, everybody was on key, and it sounded actually like a real kind of, you know, a cappella trio.
It was
something.
Very just last minute
that's
chaos.
Part of our barbershop side project.
Yeah, that's right. Gonna advance into different musical areas.
Yeah, all
very good.
From now on.
Down by the shop.
I want to talk about some of your songs too now, because you have some interesting lyrics. Counting Crows Must Die.
Yes.
Why?
Well, you know, if you hear the song, I think it's about 14 seconds long, and they're just, to me and to a lot of our fans, they're the epitome of the bad side, the evil, the dark side of the force, right? Like that's like buckskin fringe jackets in 1996, I don't think cuts it. And I just think a lot of that band is trying to be alternative, almost too much so to me. But they've got a lot of fans, probably people who love the Counting Crows. God love you. It's just, it's really more of a joke song.
Okay, and True Music, I know you guys are laughing through the whole thing anyway.
Yeah.
True Music, you sort of, you kick yourself because you'd made a video in which you didn't feel like it portrayed you. And how about this new video for Independence Day?
Yeah, absolutely, it's great. I mean, the thing about True Music was just more, like, it's very easy. I think videos are really cool. It wasn't an anti-video song. It's just a song saying it's real easy to get caught up in that and oh, wow, you're turning into rock stars, and that becomes the predominant thing, and you forget that what you're really there for, for us, is we're musicians, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And the videos are great, and I've had a great time making them, but, you know, we have to always keep our nose to the musical grindstone, you know?
Yeah, because when punk started, MTV didn't exist at all, you know, and it shouldn't really be like a necessary thing.
Mm-hmm.
And for some bands it's not, and for some it is.
Right. And you're comfortable with how you've been depicted in this video?
Oh, yeah. I mean, I'm proud of all our videos. It wasn't really anti sort of our videos. It was more like I just didn't want us to start getting so excited about being rock stars and
right,
forget that we're
stay
musicians.
Grounded.
Yeah, and that's
stay
what
grounded to your work.
We'd be doing this whether or not it sold. You know, whether we go gold or whether we sell 5 copies, it doesn't matter really,
right.
As long as we're making the music that we love and that our fans love.
You guys are playing where tonight?
The Opera House.
Opera House, catch Down by Law. This is their video, Independence Day. Thanks for making it on time.
You're welcome.
Okay.
Thank you.